Shiva, faculty of physics. I hope you are doing well in your studies in these bricks. In this episode, we are going to continue the previous episode, what we studied as heat generation capacitive circuits as part 3. Now we can discuss some more circuits in the part 4. Okay, so here you are seeing one circuit. So in this circuit there is no battery, only we have two capacitors. One is with capacitance 2 microfarad, already charged to 10 volt. Another with capacitance 1 microfarad, charged to 7 volt. Now, in order to calculate the common potential, first of all I will use loop rule. Later we can verify is the short ring water utility under the principle of conservation of charge applicable or not here clearly. Okay, first of all, so what is the total charge here before closing the switch? CV 2 into 10, that is 20. So 20 microcoulomb here minus 20 microcoulomb. Now here also this capacitor charged to 7 volt and it is having the capacitance C is 1 microfarad. Now it will become plus 7 microcoulomb. This one minus 7 microcoulomb. Now we are closing the switch. After closing the switch, this capacitor which is charged to higher potential start to discharge. This capacitor what at lower potential start to charge. And this process will continue until both capacitors will arrive at same potential. Okay, nothing but suppose we are assuming this capacitor plate loses charge Q. Now present charge it will become 20 minus Q. This Q charge added here, it will become 7 plus Q. This plate again loses the charge Q, it will become minus 7 minus Q. This Q again added here, it will become minus 20 plus Q. Okay, so in order to calculate the potential V, that is the common potential where both capacitors are arrived, first of all you can calculate the charge Q that is transferred from the capacitor at 10 volt to the capacitor at 7 volt. So first of all you can calculate the charge Q. Okay, in order to calculate the charge Q, here again I am taking some point P. From that point I am traversing in the anti-clockwise direction, that is in anti-clockwise direction what is the loop rule? Now we are moving from minus to plus. So whenever you are moving from minus to plus, the voltage of the capacitor is positive. Q by C, charge on the positive plate is 20 minus Q and its capacitance now 2 microfarad. Again we are moving in this manner. We are going through this capacitor from positive terminal to negative terminal. At that time it will become 7 plus Q by 1 is equal to 0. Okay, suppose you are moving through this circuit in the clockwise direction, what will come? I am moving through this circuit in the clockwise direction, what is the result? So instead of moving in this pattern, I am moving in this pattern. Now what I will get? Now whenever you are going through this capacitor, you are traversing from negative to positive. That's why here what we will get again? 7 plus Q by 1. Otherwise, again you are going from through this capacitor, that is plus to minus, you will get negative minus of 20 minus Q by 2 is equal to 0. Now you can use either equation. Suppose I am using this equation. By using this equation, what we can write here? 20 minus Q by 2 is equal to 7 plus Q by 1. Now it will become 20 minus q is equal to 14 plus 2q, that is 6 is equal to 3q, q will become 2 micro coulomb, nothing but after closing the switch, the final charge on this capacitor plate, 20 minus q, now what is the value of q here? 2. So 20 minus 2, it will become plus 18. Again here, minus 20 plus 2, it will become minus 18. 7 plus 2, it will become plus 9. Again, minus 7 minus 2, it will become minus 9. Okay, after calculating the charge on every plate of capacitor after closing the switch, now let us try to calculate the final potential. So what is the final potential? In order to calculate the final potential, I am using this expression V is equal to Q by C. Apply this one either this capacitor or this capacitor. So Q here, for us finally we are getting 18. Capacitance C is equal to 2, then we can write 18 by 2, otherwise this is 9 potential charge. Finally, this is capacitance 1, 9 by 1, it will become 9 volt, nothing but after closing the switch, both plates are arrived at what potential difference? 9 volt. Now let us calculate here heat energy generated. In order to calculate the heat energy generated, first of all we can calculate the EI value. So what is the value of EI here? Half into, before closing the switch, EI is total energy between the plates of capacitor before closing the switch. Before closing the switch, capacitance 2, potential 10, half CV square formula, half into 2 into 100 plus this one, half into 1 into 49, half into 1 into 49. Now what is EF? EF after closing the switch, after closing the switch, this plate or this plate, I am at what potential? At this potential. Now what we can write here? Half into C here 2, that be 981 plus half into 1 into C 1 here, 9 V value again 9, this is 81. Now what is the value of H formula? H is equal to W plus EI minus EF. Is there any battery in the circuit? There is no battery in the circuit. That's why work done by the battery will become 0. That's why W is equal to 0. So what is EI? So this is EI. Now EI you can substitute here. It will become half into, now I am taking half common by this expression where EI is this one, EF is this one. Substitute here. This EI substitute here, EF substitute here. Take half common, what we get? 200 plus 49, okay, so minus 3 into 81, okay, so 3 into 81, again we will write half into 249 minus 243, it will become half into 6, nothing but 3 micro joule, nothing but after closing the switch, during the transfer of charge, the total amount of heat energy generated in this circuit is 3 micro joule. Why this heat energy generated? The heat energy generated because of the presence of resistance. Already in the part 1 there I told you, we are not showing the resistance in the circuit is explicitly, but still we have the resistance. Even we are not showing the resistance here, why? We are neglecting the presence of the resistance by assuming the charge transfer now occur for the long interval of time and the steady state they occur. Now come to the circuit number 8 here. So in this circuit, this is a little bit different. In the previous circuit, positive plate of the capacitor is connected to the positive plate, negative plate of the capacitor here connected to the negative plate. Now come to this circuit. Here positive plate connected to negative plate, negative plate of the capacitor they connected to positive plate, nothing but polarities previously not same. But remember, even the polarities are not same, that is signs are not same, but after closing the switch, both capacitors are arrived at what potential? Same potential, such that the potential difference across the first capacitor must should be equal to the potential difference across the second capacitor. Okay, first of all, before closing the switch, what is the total charge here? So total charge now, this is plus 60 microcoulomb. Okay, what is the total charge here again? Minus 60 microcoulomb. Here CV, Q is equal to CV, C2 V10, it is plus 20 microcoulomb. Sorry, here this is sign plus or minus, no, this is not minus now, right? This plate is charged to negative, that is here we can put minus. This one will become again plus 20 microcoulomb. Okay, you can do this problem by using loop rule also, but in order to solve this problem easily, I am using the principle of conservation of energy, which states the total charge of an isolated system is constant before closing the switch, after closing the switch. Okay, so now I am concentrating on these plates, what I am showing here in the form of dotted lines. Okay, so observe carefully. Here I am showing two plates. Okay, these two plates now I am taking separately. What is the charge on this plate before closing the switch? 60 microcoulomb. What is the charge on this plate? Minus 20 microcoulomb. Total charge here 60 minus 20, 40. After closing the switch also, this charge just redistributes itself, nothing but this total charge even after redistribution also, what we can say? Same. Okay, now what we can say? Total charge, so suppose I label this one plate 1, plate 2, so total charge, so when before closing switch, before closing the switch, how much is total charge? 60 minus 20, it will become 40 microcoulomb. Okay, now we are closing the switch. Okay, so after closing the switch, what is the potential difference here? Say this potential difference something what we don't know, I am labeling this one as V. So this potential difference also something we don't know, I am labeled as V. But remember, after attaining the same potential, here also plus minus, here also plus minus. Why? Same potential implies same value for V, same sign for V. Okay. Now, again we can calculate the total charge. Total charge when? After closing, after closing switch. So after closing the switch, what is the total charge value? This is CV, this is 3V, plus this is 2V, 3V, this is 2V. So total it will become 3V plus 2V, it will become 5V. Okay. Now since our plates form what type of system? These two plates form now isolated system as well as closed system. Isolated system nothing but these two plates won't experience any force from other sources. That's why total charge here same always, before closing, after closing. Now what we can write here again based upon these ideas. So both of these are same, now equate them. Okay, so what we will get? 40 is equal to 5V. So V will become 8 volt. V will become 8 volt. Nothing but what is the final charge is now? Since V is 8 volt, what is the final charge here? So final charge will become now 8 into this one, 3 into 8. 3 into 8 will become plus 24. Here plus 24. Okay, here minus 24. Here it will become, okay, this is 2 micro coulomb, na? Final voltage what from 8. So it will become plus 16. Here it will become minus 16. Okay, so what is the total amount of charge here transferred? So previously here this is 60. Now it will becoming 24. What is the value for 60 minus 24? That is for us 36. This one loses 36 micro coulomb amount of charge. Now added here. Okay, so added here it was becoming now 16. This plate now loses 36, na? 60 minus 24, 36. 36 is last, 36 micro coulomb lost by this plate. Added to this plate, this plate previously having minus 20 micro coulomb, with addition of 36 it was becoming plus 16. Again here this one loses minus 36, loses minus 36, previously having plus 20 micro coulomb, minus 36 lost. Minus 36 lost means minus 36 plus 10 plus 20. Here you are seeing now minus 16. Again plus 36 added here, plus 36 added means minus 60 plus 36, here it will become minus 24 micro coulomb. Nothing but the charge that transferred from this plate to this entire circuit is 36 micro coulomb. Okay, now we can calculate the total energy again before closing the switch. So what is the total energy before closing the switch? So we are using this formula, half C1 V1 square plus half C2 V2 square. So half, what is the C1 value here? C1 is 3. What is V1? So V1 previously, before closing the switch, before closing the switch, this value 20 volt. So 20 volt square will become 400 plus half into, what is C2 value? C2 value here 2 into, what is the potential before closing the switch? 10 volt, 10 square, nothing but 100. Okay, similarly, what is EF? So EF indicates after closing the switch. So after closing the switch, again we are using same formula. But remember here potential or common potential, no, after closing the switch. Now what we can write here? Half into 3 into V square. V value how much? 8 volt. Okay. 8 square. 8 square it gets 64 plus half into 2 into again 8 square. It will become 64. Okay, now total amount of heat energy generated in the circuit, that is W plus EI minus EF. Are you seeing any battery in the circuit? Is there any battery in the circuit? No, no battery in the circuit. That's why there is no work done by the charge or on the charge through the battery whenever the charge is passing through the battery. So that's why, what is the value for W here? W is equal to 0. So since W is equal to 0, Just we can substitute these two expressions, EI value, EF value. What is the value of EI here? Half into 1200 plus half into 200. This value 0, na? 0 joule. Okay, minus. So what is the value for this one? Here you can see this one 64 same. 64 that I am taking out. Now we can write here half into 5 into 64. Okay. So now what we can write here again? Minus half you can take here common. 1200 plus 200 minus 54 ja 20, 56 ja 30, 320. Okay. So again we can say here half into 1400, okay, 1400 minus 320, so it will become half into, so 0, 8, 0, 1, okay. So here now what we are getting finally, so this is 540 microjoule. Okay students, now this is the topic heat generation. This topic we studied as four parts. In the part 4 what we studied? In the part 4 we took two circuits again. So one circuit where the positive plate is connected to the positive plate, negative plate also connected to the negative plate, and we calculated the total amount of heat energy generated. Again we took circuit number 8. In that circuit, positive plate of the capacitor is connected to the negative plate. Again, negative plate of the capacitor is connected to the positive plate. In that case also we calculated the common potential as well as we calculated the total amount of heat energy generated in the circuit. But remember, whenever you are doing these type of calculations, you are neglecting the presence of resistance, but still you have the resistance. That resistance only doing this job. What type of job that resistor was doing here? This resistor transferring some amount of heat energy that was given by the battery in the form of heat energy. That heat energy only we calculated totally over 4 circuits. I hope you understood this lecture well. In the next session, we will meet with one more new concept. Thank you for watching.